This is R.V. Shekhar, practicing company secretary. In this video, we are going to see the secrets of issuing shares through KIP, cost effective and alternative to public issue. What is meant by KIP? A qualified institutional placement. Recently, even in this cloud scenario, Kotak Mahindra Bank is able to raise 7,442 crore via KIP issue, qualified institutional placement issue. So a very interesting to note, even in this economic downturn during this COVID-19, Kotak Mahindra Bank gathered ₹7,442 crores through KIP, and this is very interesting one, and how I am going to explain how the salient features of KIP in this video. What is qualified institutional placement KIP? A qualified institutional placement KIP is, at its core, a way for listed companies. So in this case, only listed companies can raise capital through KIP without having to submit legal paperwork to market regulators. So they need required to produce any legal papers to SEBI. And it is common in India and other Southeast Asian countries, raising funds through KIP is common. The SEBI created the rule to avoid dependence of companies on foreign capital reserves. Why KIP has been created? To mainly to avoid to approach the foreign capital resources, KIP has been introduced. And this can be very easy to source from institutional investors. What are the chief advantages of KIP? KIP are very helpful for a couple of reasons. Their use saves time, and as the issuance of KIPs, we can save a lot of time. So there is no gap, 60 days or 90 days like that, for preparation, prospect, show of prospectus, all those things that can be saved. Not only preparation of prospect, registering with ROC and SEBI, everything, and then vetting, then consultants, legal fees, everything. So the access to capital is very far quicker than, speedier than through the FEO, and the speed is because KIPs have fewer legal rules and regulations to follow, making them much more cost effective. There are fewer legal fees and there is no cost of listing overseas. So in this type of issue, KIPs, there is no need for to pay any listing overseas and legal fees like that. It's very important to note. How KIP helps in funding? KIP is a tool used by listed companies to sell the shares or other securities which are convertible into stocks to qualified institutional buyers, only qualified institutional buyers such as mutual funds. Top KIPs in India. If you see this chart, you can understand in 2014, SBI collected 8,032 crores through KIP. Kotak Bank recently, and in 2017 also, it raised 5,800 crores. Yes Bank in 2017 raised 4,907 crores, and Arcom in 2014 it raised 4,808 crores, and Axis Bank in 2013 it raised 4,726 crores. So raising further capital by Kotak Mahindra. So on April 22, 2020, Kotak Mahindra Bank announced its plan to raise capital by selling fresh equity shares through KIP. Private lender Kotak Mahindra Bank Limited board on Saturday said it has raised at least 7,442 crores via issuance of 65 million shares in a qualified institutional placement KIP. Kotak Mahindra Bank raised ₹7,442.5 crores through KIP. Following the board meeting, the bank said that shares have been offered to investors at ₹11.45 a piece, which is at a discount of 6.43 to the current market price of ₹12,223.70. SEBI regulation says a company which want to go for KIP, they can offer up to 5% maximum discount on the current market price of the issue shares. institutional investors took major shares in Quip. See, this, as you know, the Quip is mainly intended for Quip, major institutional investors. The institutional investors in Kotak Bank, including Invesco Op, Oppenheimer Developing Market Fund, Canada Pension Plan Investment Board, and ICICI Prudential Asset Management Company, have been allotted 8.02, 7.12, and 6.30% of total offer size, respectively. The ICICI Mutual Fund bought shares through 18 of its mutual fund schemes in the Quip, which was opened on 26th May 2020 and closed on 29th May 2020. Avenue Supermarkets. Earlier, Avenue Supermarkets also went in first Quip to hit the public markets, which runs supermarket chain in DMart, like DMart, raised 4,098 crore in February 2020 last year, this year. Say, fundraising via Quip amount in financial year 2016, 19,358 crore have been raised. In financial year 2017, rupees 13,671 crores have been raised. In financial year 18, 62,520 crores have been raised. And financial year 19, 10,489 crores. And financial year 20, up to this May, companies have raised 51,216 crores. Present rules. Quip price should not be less than the average of weekly high and low for 2 weeks preceding the issue. So the price fixation will be like that. It should not exceed the average weekly high and low for the 2 weeks preceding the issue. A further discount of up to 5% on the share floor price can be offered to the investors. This is allowed under the SEBI. Kotak Bank's Quip's issue. Kotak Bank had said that 26th May that it had set a floor price of 1147.75 paise per share for the offering. As per SEBI norms, the bank can offer a maximum discount of 5% on the floor price to its investors. Kotak Mahindra Bank will use these funds to bolster its balance sheet and strengthen its capital. What is the purpose of the quit issue for Kotak Mahindra? Mainly to enhance its balance sheet and strengthen its capital buffer. Like many other Indian banks, Kotak Mahindra Bank will use this process of Quip primarily to bolster its balance sheet and strengthen its capital buffers as the lockdown caused by COVID-19 pandemic is expected to lead to potentially higher slippages in the coming quarters. The bank may also use the capital to tap opportunities arising out of the crisis. So it is one of the reasons for this issue is to cross over the COVID-19 situation and to make good the slippages in the coming quarters in the market. To augment capital base and strengthen balance sheet of Quip. Subject to applicable laws and regulations, our bank, Kotak Mahindra Bank, intends to use the net proceeds to augment its capital base and strengthen its balance sheet, which would assist Kotak Mahindra Bank in dealing with the contingencies of or financing business opportunities, which may be organic or inorganic or both, which may arise pursuant to the economic events driven by the outbreak of COVID or otherwise. The bank said in its draft offer documents on 26th May 2020. So Kotak Mahindra Bank's capital adequacy ratio is 18 as against the industrial standards of 19. One of the main thing is success is it's a capital adequacy ratio of Kotak Mahindra Bank. The bank's capital adequacy ratio is around 18% at present. Banks are currently required to maintain a capital adequacy ratio of CAR at 9%. CAR is the ratio of lender's capital as compared to its risk-weighted assets, cash, loans, investments, etc. and current liabilities, taxes, interest, expenses, deposits, etc. If the companies in India wants to strengthen their fiscal position, mainly listed companies, they may use Quip to raise capital with the least cost, as successfully shown by Kotak Mahindra Bank, Avenue Supermarket Limited, State Bank, Arcom, and other companies. So I suggest that listed companies in India can use this method. This is not only time saving, cost effective, no legal fees involved, no listing fees involved in foreign companies. It's very easy to. So the Kotak Bank, Mahindra Bank, made a draft offer on 26th May and closed on 30th May and is able to get funds of 7,400 crores. It's a very amazing. So it's the best way for the listing companies in India to go for public issue and collect the funds to augment the balance sheet. Friends, thanking you for seeing this video. I request you to like this video, share this video, and also subscribe my channel so that whenever I issue new videos on various subjects in future, it will reach you directly. Thanking you. This is R. V. Shagar, practicing company secretary.